What's going on, guys? It's Jimmy here. Welcome to our daily show where we discuss the fourth stimulus check update, the stimulus package update, the $3.5 trillion, which is in the final stages of the House of Representatives. And they're trying to pass that as well as the physical infrastructure package, which almost had the final vote in the House of Representatives. Nancy Pelosi says that they might be having the final vote on that today. The problem with that is that they're going through the negotiation process as the physical infrastructure package has the fate of that is tied, the physical infrastructure package and the $3.5 trillion stimulus package, their fates are tied together with the Democrats and Senator Joe Manchin. They're really trying to negotiate on a deal going forward. Senator Joe Manchin says he now only wants to spend at most $1.5 trillion. And a lot of the progressive Democrats have backed off on that physical infrastructure package, saying they're not going to vote for the physical infrastructure package now because Senator Joe Manchin says he only wants to spend $1.5 trillion. And Joe Manchin really wants to pass the physical infrastructure package. So there's going to be a lot of give and take here as Joe Manchin's going to have to negotiate on both of these deals here. So we're going to give the latest information on that, as well as the debt limit ceiling, which has to be negotiated on or passed on as well in the next 17 days, or America will default on its debt obligations for the first time ever and will not be able to pay its bills if they can't pass a bill on the debt limit ceiling, which means the United States Treasury will literally run out of money. And I'm going to be letting you guys know what debts and what payments like Social Security and what will be at risk. I actually have an article that states that directly from a credible news source. So yeah, I'm getting a lot of questions. Will Social Security be at risk? Will the child tax credit payments be at risk? What is actually at risk here within as little as 2 weeks here, as we just had the government shutdown averted to keep the government open. But the government shutdown is different than the debt limit ceiling, where the government will literally run out of money. The government cannot print more money or raise the debt limit ceiling without passing a new bill for the debt limit ceiling. Right now, the Republicans are not allowing the Democrats to pass a new bill to raise the debt limit ceiling. That bill failed in the Senate twice, and the Republicans are just literally not allowing the Democrats to do that. Two votes failed. The Republicans want the Democrats to do it through the reconciliation process, which is a lengthy process that right now the Democrats don't have the votes to do it. And the Democrats also say they don't have the time to do it. And if they don't do it, the United States is going to default, which is similar to saying the country is going to go bankrupt on its debt obligations, literally run out of money. Right now, they're using a reserve account that had $450 billion in it on August 1st, when they started to use this reserve account, the Treasury Department did, which is when they should have passed the bill to raise the debt limit ceiling. Yeah. So let's jump right in. If you're new to the channel, make sure to subscribe down below. I'll keep you up to date with the next stimulus package, the physical infrastructure package, and everything going on in our country. Make sure to subscribe down below. New videos come out every day at 10 a.m., 3 p.m., and 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Subscribing is completely free to do so. Also, don't forget to hit the like button for us down below. It really helps out our channel. So as you can see here from CBS News, this article, there's many, many articles, interviews. I show you here. I'm on the channel all the time. The United States could run out of cash, that's correct, to pay the bills on October 18th, says Treasury Secretary Janet Yellen, if Congress doesn't act on the debt ceiling by October 18th, which is called the X date. The date that the United States will literally run out of cash. That's correct. So we have a little bit over 2 weeks. Now, this is an estimated date. It could come a little bit before then. It could come a little bit after then, depending on, remember that the U.S. government runs a deficit. So that means every single day, the U.S. government spends a little bit more money than they make. It's been this way for many, 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 many years, whether you have a Republican president, a Democratic president. It's been going on this way for a long time. And I have this other very, very interesting article here for you guys. I've been getting a lot of questions, literally thousands of questions from you guys, because this is really big news here. This is also from CBS News. Debt limit ceiling. These are the federal payments that are at risk if the U.S. defaults. And this is very big news because right now the Republicans are not allowing the Democrats to raise the debt limit ceiling. The vote has failed twice in the Senate. And the Democrats are also saying that they probably lack the time to raise the debt limit on their own through the reconciliation process. And House Speaker Nancy Pelosi and Senate Majority Leader Chuck Schumer, as you can see here from this article from The Hill from September 29th, says the Democrats cannot and will not raise the debt limit ceiling through the reconciliation process. They cannot and will not. So Democrats are saying the reconciliation process is out. That's the process that they're going to pass the stimulus package through. But the Democrats want to do it through a vote in the Senate. They can do it through a simple majority vote with 50 to 51 votes, simply through unanimous consent, which is actually a process they tried. It was like 24 to 48 hours ago in the Senate. It's actually a process that the Democrats allowed the Republicans to raise the debt limit ceiling for. It was like 8 to 10 years ago to raise the debt limit before that the Republicans did. The Democrats allowed the Republicans to raise the debt limit ceiling before. Ironically, the Republicans are just not allowing the Democrats to do it right now. If the Republicans just allow the Democrats to do this, this whole problem would go away. The Democrats could then raise the debt limit ceiling without a single Republican vote. The Republicans just have to say, okay, we unanimously consent to let you do this without the filibuster rule with just the 50 to 51 votes that the Democrats can do. 50 Democrats in the Senate, all the Republicans vote no. Then the 51st vote goes, the tiebreaker vote goes to the Vice President of the United States, Kamala Harris. Then the debt limit ceiling gets raised, and then nobody has to miss Social Security payments. The full faith and credit of the United States doesn't have to get ruined, or no financial collapse, or no stock market collapse, or anything like that. But the Republicans are not willing to do that, so then this is what could happen. Okay, so here we are, CBS News. These are the federal payments at risk if the U.S. defaults. And I've seen a lot of comments in the comment section below that some people are saying that the Republicans might want to see this happen because the Democrats control the House, the Senate, and the presidency. So I don't know. You guys can let me know your thoughts down below in the comments. We really hope this doesn't happen. But here are the payments that could be at risk if this does happen. Remember, this has never happened before. The U.S. has never defaulted before. So here's the payments that are or could be at risk if this does happen. Number one, the Social Security payments on October 20th and October 27th. About 65 million payments receive Social Security each month. These would be the payments, obviously, after the default date of October 18th. So if the country defaults on October 18th, they don't come to an agreement, they don't pass a bill, then Social Security payments could be delayed or missed after that point, as you can see here on the screen. You can see here, even a short delay would cause financial strain on many. 40% of Social Security recipients count on the benefit for more than 90% of their income. And for two-thirds of them, it counts for nearly half of their income. Yes, they may be paid in a few weeks or a few months whenever it's resolved, but that doesn't deal with the problem of making decisions like, I'm going to buy my medicine, I'm going to pay my rent, am I going to buy food, am I going to buy utilities? Because these are things that aren't going to be waiting, said Max Richman, president and CEO of the National Committee to Preserve Social Security and Medicare. it would put a serious financial squeeze on many, if not most, Social Security beneficiaries if they are not paid in full on time. The next thing is the child tax credit payments on October 15th. Now note that this is slightly before the X date on October 18th, so keep that in mind. But if the government hits the X date, which on October 15th, slightly earlier than the Treasury estimate, it could lead to a delay in the fourth installment going out of these monthly payments of $250 to $300 per month going out to 65 million children, or about 40 million households. Policy experts have attributed monthly child tax credit payments for helping cut child poverty rates in the U.S. in nearly half. Veteran benefits on November 1st, again, same thing. Nation's veterans could see a number of different monthly benefits that range from disability compensations to pensions to survivor benefits at risk. Federal salaries on October 15th and the 29th, there are more than 2 million people on the federal workforce. If the government can't pay its debts, their salaries could also be at risk. Medicaid, more than 80 million people are enrolled to receive benefits from Medicaid or from the Children's Health Insurance Program. 80 million people. Again, if the government can't pay its bills, Medicaid, 80 million people could be at risk. Next program is SNAP, the food stamps program. 42 million people are participating in this program, could be at risk, all because Congress can't come to an agreement. So yeah, when you count up the tens or hundreds of millions of people and the financial collapse and everything there, you've seen it there in black and white. That's from CBS News, and I've literally read all sorts of articles. We've seen all sorts of interviews from senators and congressmen, Treasury Secretary, major financial and just all sorts of economic consequences here. So let's hope that Democrats and Republicans can figure this situation out. I will keep you up to date on that, as well as the next stimulus package and the physical infrastructure package, which we'll talk about now. And the big issue of today is that Senator Joe Manchin, the Democrat Republican, is he a Democrat or a Republican? Well, that question is yet to be determined. He says he's a Democrat, but he's maybe a dino, a Democrat in name only. He's being questioned today by a lot of his Democrats. Check this out.
I believe that there are some that don't want to pass both bills. And I think that what we've seen from the influence of corporate lobbyists in Washington, that is absolutely part of the conversation. And that's why we want to secure a path to passage on both of these bills.
Senator Manchin was asked about some of that criticism today.
What do you say to people who feel you and Senator Sinema are holding this whole thing up?
We wouldn't have 50 votes. Basically take whatever we aren't able to come to agreement with today and take that on the campaign trail next year, and I'm sure that they'll get many more liberal, progressive Democrats with what they say they want.
Yeah, Senator Joe Manchin has been getting absolutely blasted over the last few hours, 12 to 24 hours, as he has come out and said he wants to spend a max $1.5 trillion. And we have now more and more Democrats saying, well, they're not going to pass the physical infrastructure package in the House, which Senator Joe Manchin really greatly wants to pass, as the two bills are linked. And the progressive Democrats, which are more left-leaning, I guess I should be over here, and Joe Manchin is more right-leaning, more Republican-leaning, are kind of at odds. And Joe Manchin's kind of off on an island on his own at $1.5 trillion. He's the only Democrat that has come up with a number on his own at $1.5 trillion. He just kind of made up a number on his own, didn't come up with, you know, he didn't mathematically calculate this number. It's not like he came up with he added it all up and came up with a number. $1.732 trillion needs to be the number. He just came up with a nice round number of $1.5 trillion, that's what I want to spend. That's all I'm spending. You know, it's like a kid at a at a playground saying, no, I only want to spend $1.5 trillion, and that's all I'm spending. And all the other Democrats are looking at him like, where did you come up with this number? And that's not what anybody else wants to spend. All the other Democrats, 98% of them, are at $3.5 trillion. I mean, sure, maybe some of them want to spend a little bit less, but nobody wants to spend $1.5 trillion. But nonetheless, they need Joe Manchin because they need 50 senators to pass this bill. Here's Democratic Congressman Mark Pocan from the Progressive Caucus on how a lot of Democrats are just slamming Joe Manchin. And how President Biden himself could be at risk if they don't pass this package. And we're really the whole country could be at risk because seniors not getting Medicare, 65 million children not getting the child tax credit monthly payments. They go away at the end of this year. If this package isn't passed, those monthly payments stop. I mean, there's so many things in this package that would not get passed, all potentially because of Joe Manchin.
Leader of the Progressive Caucus, who has been taking a very hard line. If she sees what Manchin is willing to go for, and you all know that the Biden presidency is really on the line here. If this fails, he becomes a lame duck going into midterms almost. You know, it's a really tough vote to lose, as Pelosi as well. So you believe that the caucus, which is now 60-some strong, 90 strong, but you've got 60 votes willing to stick it out with, like, at least that, right? You're willing to go for a scaled-back reconciliation bill, and not today, not tomorrow, but sometime in a week or two.
I really believe the president's agenda includes both bills. Very clearly, he had a $6 trillion proposal that's been brought down to $3.5 trillion through compromise. Apparently, there'll be a little more compromise. But if you just have the infrastructure bill, $550 billion additional dollars, that's 9% of what President Biden wants. So I think we have the president's back in getting his full agenda done. And I do think that the real issue, and I disagree with Senator Manchin on this, is I wouldn't want to go back to Arizona or West Virginia and explain how you killed child care, affordable child care for your constituents, the child tax credit that 40 million American families are going to benefit from. I mean, that's the important stuff that's in this Build Back Better Act. So we're going to get both bills done. It may not be pretty. It may be the storm before the calm. But I'm still very confident, as is Speaker Pelosi, we're going to get this done.
But he seems to be focused not on the child care, but focused on the coal and not wanting to take those climate provisions back to West Virginia and wanting some kind of sign-off on legislation going through his committee.
Well, and I think Senator Sinema might have some other bottom lines. But at some point, we need everyone to put their bottom lines down in front of us so we can have the final negotiations, and we'll figure it out. But these are big ideas that real people in our districts are going to benefit from. Affordable child care, that child tax break 40 million American families benefit from. Lowered costs on prescription drugs. I mean, finally, insulin. 100 years ago, they sold the patent for a dollar each to the three people, so it'd be in there the public good, and we pay hundreds of dollars for insulin on a regular basis. We're going to get all of that done in the Build Back Better Act, and I'm confident it doesn't matter when it gets done as far as today or next week or the following week. What really matters is we get the agenda done for the president, because it's really the agenda for the American people.
And, Congressman, what do you think about Senator Sinema? I mean, I know there's always House-Senate rivalry, but even among her colleagues, getting to a place where someone asked her at a stakeout last night, you know, where are you right now, meaning on the legislation, and she said facetiously, I'm standing in front of the elevator. I'm paraphrasing, but it was flip, it was not substantive, and there's a lot of criticism of a freshman senator behaving like this on something this important.
Yeah, I think, being coy and maybe bad humor is time for that to end. What we need to do is, just like Senator Manchin did, and I give him credit, is he's telling us what he stands for, and that's what the president asked for last week. It may have taken him a week to do that, but he's doing that. We need Senator Sinema to do the exact same thing, and then I think we can really have the progress we need to finalize this bill.
And speaking of insulin costs, Senator Joe Manchin's daughter is actually involved in an insulin scandal with a pharmaceutical company where she was involved in raising the cost of insulin on an insulin scandal. You can look into it. It's a very I don't even know the word to put it this way, not good people. But she was involved in raising the cost of insulin, Senator Joe Manchin's daughter. Yeah, it's, and Joe Manchin has been accused of being sponsored heavily by corporations. And it makes you kind of wonder why Joe Manchin is the one and only Democrat that, and you really heard AOC mention that, being sponsored by corporations, and you gotta wonder if she's talking about Joe Manchin. And the question is, will Joe Manchin come along? He came along in the third stimulus check package. He ultimately voted yes. Will he come along with this next stimulus package, or do you think he would actually be the one and only Democrat that would vote no? Do you think they would get 49 Democrats or 48 Democrats to say yes in the Senate and the bill would fail? Do you think that the Democrats could lose the Senate, lose the presidency because of one Democrat? Let me know your thoughts. I personally don't think that it happened. It didn't happen with the third stimulus check package. I think that he would literally lose his Senate seat if that were to happen. I think he knows that. I think that he'll come along. I think it's part of his negotiation strategy. I also think that he likes his 15 minutes of fame, and I think that he likes to drag that on as long as possible. But let me know your thoughts on Joe Manchin down below in the comments. I'm sure there will be some interesting comments on Joe Manchin. Keep him clean in the comments section. But yeah, so I'll keep you up to date on the infrastructure package, the stimulus package. Remember, their fates are tied together, because there's a lot of progressive Democrats that won't vote yes on the physical infrastructure package if the if Joe Manchin won't come along and come with an agreement on the stimulus package. And a lot of the Democrats want the stimulus package to be voted on first, especially because of Joe Manchin now coming forward with this. So I'll keep you up to date on the stimulus package, the debt limit ceiling, and the physical infrastructure package here on this channel, and everything else that you need to know about going on in our country. So make sure to subscribe down below. It's completely free to do so. You literally just need to click subscribe. And then if you want to get notifications when we go live, which is every day at 10 a.m., 3 p.m., and 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, after subscribing, click the bell icon, and then click all notifications to get reminders when we go live with new videos. You can click this video here to watch my newest stimulus check video next. And this video is our family channel, Julian's Adventures, where we just uploaded a new video with my son Julian and my wife Laurel, where we just went to the Asian Lights Festival, and my son and my wife had a blast. So click on one of those videos next. Thanks, guys, and I will see you in the next video.